everybody, my name is Dreadeye, and welcome to Five Nights at Freddy's 3. Now, I know I said Five Nights at Freddy's 2 in the channel revamp video, but since I'm already to night 6 in Five Nights at Freddy's 2, I figured that you all would want some fresh jump scares. I've never touched Five Nights at Freddy's 3, so let's see how this goes. So it's Freddy Fazbear's Fright, Fazbear's Fright, the horror attraction. Oh man. Fungi!
Huh. Hey, glad you came back for another night. I promise it'll be a lot more interesting this time. We found some great new relics over the weekend. And we're out tracking down a new lead right now. So, let me just update you real quick, then you can get to work. Like, the attraction opens in like a week. So we have to make sure everything works and nothing catches on fire. When the place opens, people will come in at the opposite end of the building and work their way toward you, then pass you and out the exit. Yeah, you've officially become part of the attraction. You'll be starring as the security guard. So not only will you be monitoring the people on the cameras, you know, to make sure no one steals anything or fakes out in the corner, but you'll also be a part of the show. It'll make it feel really authentic, I think. Now let me tell you about what's new.
Found
another set of drawings, always nice, and the foxy head, which we think could be authentic. Then again, it might just be another crappy cosplay. And we found a desk fan, very old school, metal though.
More fan.
Oh, the fan.
Right now the place is basically just, you know, flashing lights, spooky props. I honestly thought we'd have more by now. We don't have something really cool by next week. We may have to suit you up in our furry suit.
Hello.
But, you know, like I said, we're trying to track down a good lead right now. Some guy who helped design one of the buildings said it was like an extra room that got boarded up, or something like that. So, we're gonna take a peek and see what we can find. For now, just get comfortable with the new setup. You can check the security cameras over to your right with the click of that blue button. You can toggle between the hall cams and the vent cams. Then over to your far left, you can flip up your maintenance panel. You know, use this to reboot any systems that may go offline. In trying to make the place feel vintage, we may have overdone it a bit. Some of this equipment is barely functional. Yeah, I wasn't joking about the fire. That's a real risk. The most important thing you want to watch for is the ventilation. Look, this place will give you the spooks, man. And if you let that ventilation go offline, then you'll start seeing some crazy stuff, man. Keep that air flowing. Okay, keep an eye on things, and we'll try to have something new for you tomorrow night.
So it's 4 a.m. already. And this place is creepy as crap. I don't even know how to turn on the lights. Oh my god. What is that? Are there no lights in this game? That's creeping me out right there. Like I said, I've never played this game before. Is one of these buttons. A light? By any chance? Yeah! I did it. Oh. We get a mini game already? Hey. What's going on? Oh, it's a purple bear. It's storming outside. Like, literally in real life. And in the game, I hear rain sounds. What is going on? I can't. What? What was that? Alright, so I'm gonna save the second night for next episode, so I'll see you guys then. Bye, guys.